The Miner's Lot by Ellen Sharp is based in the late 1940s, early 1950s, at a time when there was planning and starting to build the Pithead Baths. This is Ellen's uncle Eric, who worked at it was a collier, talking to Auntie Louie. How many towels does she want then, Louie? You know, you have to take potluck with colours, don't you? Some colours are a bit bright, but I can't pick and choose what I want. Once you ain't queue at canteen counter, you have to take what's given you.
Just bring a couple for now, Eric. We are going to miss these cheap towels and soap when a pithead bath's coming, aren't we? Must get a good stock of both in while we can.
Talking about soap, I'll get two lots while I'm there and open them both bags. See if there's any of that pink stuff in. Stinks to high heaven, just like one of them there French brothels.
Just how the dickens do you know what a French brothel smells like, Eric? Just tell me that.
Well, you know what I mean, cheap and tarty. You can't beat a bit of carbolic now, can you? Come on then, let's be honest, can you?
No, I suppose not. Mind you, the green one smells nice and fresh. Just do what you can, lad.
Aye, I will. Can I do no more? Here, look at that clock. It's all right for us standing about, gabbing about soap and towels. I've got a shifter to buy up it for us, else we'll have no money to buy out with. Where's my snap woman? Shall I get bath down now, or shall I wait till they get on? Hey, that's one thing I shall miss when pithead baths open, without filling that old damn bath every day. Can I wait till next year?
See you, Duck. Be careful. So with his water bottle and snap tin containing his homemade plum jam sandwiches hanging from his belt, off he would go to walk the 2 miles to work. For years, miners had brought the dust and dirt from the coalface home with them to share with their wives and children. At the end of a stint, a black face would appear round the door, recognisable only by the white teeth and smiling eyes. Just glad to be home safe and sound, and not too badly hurt from another shift down the hellhole. Many's the time my Uncle Eric came home, with his helmet hanging from his belt, and blood running down his face from a roof fall that had split his head open. Or hopping on one foot, boot in hand, again because of yet another fall, this time onto his foot while he was trying to put pit props in place. The toe cap of the boot would have cut straight into his toes sometimes, down to the bone. Treatment was very basic, if not very painful and barbaric. Undiluted Dettol would see off any germs and bacteria. It was poured directly into the wound neat, wherever it was, and left to do its work. Next day would see him back at work. Remember, they had to complete 5 shifts to get their weekly bonus or any overtime that was going. This was a time when men were men and proud of it. What went wrong?